Ära pane seda muusikat, ma arvan, et ei ole vaja. Ei ole vaja seda muusikat. So. Hi everybody, tere. Maybe I'm wrong person at the wrong place because I know nothing about marketing. But see on esimest korda, kui ma inglise keeles räägin. Ma isegi ei tea, miks ma seda teen. Palju on siin neid, kes ei saa aru, kui ma ütlen, et kõik ingliskeelt räägivad inimesed on munnid. No, selle naeru järgi siin aru, et osad saavad aru. Okei, okay, let's back to English. My worldview is something like old-fashioned and I believe Gorgias got it right 2,500 years ago when he said that nothing exists. Even if something exists, nothing can be known about it. And even if something can be known about it, knowledge about it can't be communicated to others. And even if it can be communicated, it cannot be understood. So there is nothing I know. Even if I know something, I can tell about it. And even if I can tell about it, you can understand nothing. So no harm done today. I never worked in a startup, in a startup sense that when you're you have ideas and you don't have money, you go begging around money. I always prefer to work with the people who have money. So we started a couple of companies some, I don't know, 10, 12 years ago. And from that on, I always choose the people with the money to work. So. There is a short list of things that I learned in these years, and so I tell you, but I think you can learn nothing about it. So first of all, be secretive. Your friends, lovers, partners, bankers, investors, clients, everything is sensitive information. Never share it. If put under pressure, lie. If in media there's an image that you have certain friends, well, I have one of my banker friends, everyone knows, Rain Lahmus, Raiko. All the people think that that's my only friend. So they ask me about it, I say, yeah, Rain. I have like, I don't know, maybe, I know hundreds of bankers, I have a couple of more, much more closer friends, but I never admit it, never. So don't do conferences, keynotes, nothing, unless you have very specific reason. Well, you have maybe new iPhone to present to world, yes. Or you're broke and need free food and free drinks. Or you want to impress a girl or a boy. Or you want to secretly masturbate in front of young people. You want to do some maybe these things. Or you're bored. Or you're perfecting your stand-up routine where you get paid. So why I'm here. Second, avoid fame at all cost. Always, always prefer money. Fame is cheap substitute for money. It helps to get laid, but not by far as much as a private jet. I know. Go public only if you can't avoid it. Never talk money publicly. Never. It's like people don't know. Maximum amount of money you speak publicly is, I don't know, medium salary. Never talk about real money in public. Talk ideas, world peace, solar energy, green solutions, talk fucking crazy creativity. Whatever is populist enough. Never tell what you think because you don't know what you think. And if you're already locally famous, no big deal. Make things in countries where they don't know you. So that's why I'm a worldwide celebrity known only locally in Estonia. So that's why my operations are a bit more difficult in Estonia, but there are other countries to do your things. Public relations. The best relations are the secret relations. Cultivate private communication channels to key politicians, bankers, journalists, the police, regulators, criminals, businessmen. So why do it publicly? Have breakfast, lunches, dinners, tell stories, listen stories. Do it Godfather's way. Do favors and add clause that one day you'll come back asking a favor for yourself. Change laws, change rules, call it competitive edge, a unique selling point, the actual thing you're after, unfair, criminal, monopolistic death grip of market. However, never admit it, even to yourself. Well, that's the basic thing everyone must always remember. So be selective. Most of the things we want in the life are in the position of other people. So if you want sex, you better hang with the people you want to have sex with. If you want money, hang with the people who have it. Discard and avoid politely childhood friends, relatives, schoolmates who have nothing that you want. That's true. Don't waste your time. Robin Dunbar, who's an evolutionary psychologist, tells that there is a biological limit to the number of people we can communicate with. So be selective, make everyone count, work with the best. Big picture. Never, ever share any of the insights you have about the big picture. Never. Always deny there even is a big picture. Talk only specific tasks, specific rewards. Learn to live in the world where there is absolutely no one you can share what and how you want to achieve at the end. Whenever possible, answer to every question, I don't know. People feel then extremely smart at your company. So I don't know. Give back, always give back. And I don't mean community, never. I mean people. Everyone who works for you must get something out of it. A bribe, kickback, fee, salary, fame, exclusive information, occasional one-night stand, whatever. Whatever works. It cannot and always must take some form. Everyone is for sale. The only question is that of money and the competence of the buyer. Don't get into arguments, just withhold payments. Once the milestones are achieved, release the payments. Be honest. It takes a couple of sentences to tell exactly what you want. Don't waste other people's time. Never write when you can show a video. Ask what you want people to do. If you want something, someone to publish it, write it down and let them publish it, sign their name over it. So never write longer than one page. Longer pieces are for lawyers or entertainers. One page is honest. Longer than that, lies insecurity, fear, and incompetence. Every idea must be a maximum one page. But you have to be really honest. And it means that if you have something really unique and important to say, this that can offer instant profits, it just can't be written down because it's illegal, yes? But this is actually what everyone wants to hear. Do you have it? If not, don't waste people's time. Be an outsider. That's a very old truth that stranger gets the better fuck than the husband. Baudelaire, Camus, everyone has written poems, stories about it. You have to be in the perfect place at perfect time with the perfect offer. Offer low risk, high return, one-off deals and move on. Never brag, never. Do your killing and move on. Buy trust. Give money on first possible moment. You have to be really careful that you enter money into equation first possible moment. Don't never delay the moment because maybe the moment, that's the competence of the buyer. Give praise, choose sides. If you like something, say it. Really publicly, preferably privately. But let people do the things, but let people who do the things you like know it. Businessmen, artists, writers, filmmakers, bankers, politicians, journalists. If they are in the controversial position, take a side. Sometimes publicly, give your support. You're gonna need it someday too. If you pick winners, you're a winner. If not, entertain. People want shopping, sex, hunting, drinking, whatever. Make it easy for people to help you do what you want and then help them do what they want. So, for example, foreign direct investment is possible only because middle-aged, bald, fat guys want fresh fuck. I've been in the business, I know. Yeah, and it's not the way I made it, just the world was ready when I got there. Emerging markets translate, wow, you can't imagine what that young whore did for a $1. So international financial centers translates here, yes, we can bend over. Localization, never bother too much. Jay-Z and Rihanna never translate their raps and songs into Latvian, do they? English is most important, but what I know about it. Well, but they never notice your grammar, punctuation, or pronunciation if you speak cash. Human touch. Don't ever talk politics, history, wars, genocide, nations, languages, sexual orientation, human rights, sports. These topics are for professionals who have their agendas. You're an amateur, you will get killed. Talk tasks, hint money. Always tell people how you honor their values, principles, history, ideas, privacy, ideals, religion, opinion, everything, so you have to pay them less cash. And never express your opinion of your own in these matters. Don't analyze and don't look back. Just do the things, get into action and see how it turns out. Always take credit for everything you didn't do. Never admit what you actually did. Learn to quickly forget the successes you achieved. Concentrate on the next task. Delete emails, documents, messages. Destroy hard drives frequently. Never use paper. And social media, marketing, advertising, PR, that was today's topic. Well, this is real work. Hire people to do it. Spend as little you can. Do real deals yourself and never publicly tell about it, but let the marketing people wrestle with the marketing. It's an unavoidable nuisance like accounting or plumbing. It just has to be done. Override, cancel, change their ideas whichever way you want. If you pay, you decide. Well, but don't mess with the plumbers, though. And there's one story. I was in a week-long cocaine binge in some 15 years ago. And I heard it, and it taught me more about marketing than all the books in the world. Well, one guy, young, bright guy, violent, has just stolen the databases of the young independent country, all police databases. So he decided that's the excellent way to start information services phone line. So he was sitting in the office and realized that no one is paying him any money. It's like excellent databases. People are calling in asking information, but no one is paying him. So he gives out information about the companies to callers, but no one is paying for advertising. So he asked me, what was the fundamental obstacle that no one paid the bills? I was young and fresh and stupid. And I start mumbling about brand recognition, advertising, marketing, things like this. He said, no, they didn't have the invoices. So he hired a couple of accountants and they started printing out and mailing out official looking invoices to each and every company in database. And he had a really good database. 1 in 10 started paying next month. So, and after 15 years, there are still accountants from other companies calling in, where is this month invoice? So that's it, steal and send invoices. Thanks.